In this video, I'm reviewing the new and most definitely improved Earlens hearing aid system. Coming up. Hi guys, Cliff Olson, Doctor of Audiology and founder of Applied Hearing Solutions in Phoenix, Arizona. And on this channel, I cover a bunch of hearing related information to help make you a better informed consumer. So if you're into that, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And don't forget to click the bell to receive a notification every time I post a new video. A few years ago, I published a review video about the Earlens light-driven hearing aid system based on my experiences with this revolutionary technology that promised to give better hearing performance than a traditional hearing aid. In that video, I mentioned a number of shortcomings of the Earlens light-driven hearing aid system and basically came to the conclusion that due to the extremely high cost, the lack of reliability, and the complex delivery model of that particular hearing aid, that the Earlens light-driven hearing aid was more trouble than it was worth. The good news is, Earlens learned from all the positive and negative feedback that they received from their original light-driven hearing aid and decided to pivot away from this technology and move it in a different direction. Now, if this is the first time that you're hearing about Earlens, let me go ahead and give you a quick explanation about what Earlens is and how it compares to a traditional hearing aid. In general, traditional hearing aids amplify sounds to make those sounds more audible to an individual with hearing loss. Sound is picked up by a microphone either behind your ears or inside of your ears. That sound is then processed by the hearing aid and amplified according to your hearing loss prescription. That sound is then put into your ear canal to vibrate your eardrum at a more intense level than what that natural sound would have done. The original light-driven system was designed in a completely different way. So let me go ahead and actually play a video on what this device actually did.
The Earlens light-driven hearing aid has three major parts. The photon processor, the light tip, and the lens. The small custom fit lens is placed in your ear by an ear, nose, and throat physician. The lens stays in place on your ear the same way a contact lens stays in place on your eye, with surface tension. Sound enters the microphones on the rechargeable behind the ear processor. The processor communicates the sound to the light tip, which converts the sound into non-visible light. The light signals the lens to gently activate your natural hearing system.
So instead of amplifying sounds like what you would do with a traditional hearing aid, they actually converted that sound into a light impulse that could directly drive your eardrum. This method of stimulating better hearing actually has advantages over traditional hearing aids in that you get a broader frequency range of amplification and you can leave the ear canals open and still be able to stimulate low frequency hearing. However, the flaws in this original design led the company to completely switch away from this method of directly driving the eardrum. The biggest flaw that they had and the biggest reason for the change is that when you had that ear tip inside of someone's ear, that light had to be directly pointing at that lens. And so anytime someone would chew on food or smile or anything like that, it would take the tip of that light source and actually make it miss the lens altogether, which completely negated all the benefit of this device. This is why Earlens decided to abandon the light tip design and switch to an inductive power design. However, the overall concept remains completely unchanged. They want to be able to directly drive the eardrum with the lens that sits on the eardrum. They're just changing the way that they drive that lens. Instead of using a light source, they're using inductive power. Inductive power does not require a direct line of sight, so you can chew on food, you can smile all you want, and the hearing aid is going to continue to work. So what are some of the other good things about this inductive power Earlens system? First, you still get a broader frequency response with Earlens versus a traditional hearing aid. Instead of capping out at around 6,000 Hz for a traditional hearing aid, Earlens can go all the way up to 10,000 Hz, which actually gives you more audibility at higher frequency ranges of hearing loss. Some research suggests that the benefits of this could actually improve music appreciation and the ability to understand speech in quiet and background noise. Second, Earlens can actually amplify low frequency sound waves even though they leave your ear canals completely open. You see, one of the problems with traditional hearing aids is that low frequency sounds cannot be amplified and actually stay inside the ear unless you actually close off the ear canal. But this is completely different with Earlens. They can have an open vent on the tip of their earpiece and still allow in some natural low frequency sounds, but even amplify low frequency sounds inside of your ear without having to worry about those sounds leaking out. Not only does this allow you to amplify low frequencies with an open ear canal, but this allows you to also prevent the occlusion effect, which is that perception of your own voice being really boomy and loud when you have your ears plugged up with something. And due to the direct drive aspect of how Earlens works, it can actually improve the quality of streaming sound from your smart device. This open ear tip also helps to prevent insertion loss, which is that effect that you get when you put something inside of your ears and it blocks some of your natural hearing, making your hearing a little bit worse, so you then have to go in and amplify on top of it. Third, the Earlens system can actually apply negative insertion gain, which basically means that they can apply some form of active noise cancellation. This allows for better functioning of directional microphones, signal processing, and noise reduction. And fourth, the new Earlens inductive system has seemed to overcome some of the major problems that were plaguing the old technology, which was reliability and consistent performance. Now, I've spoken to a number of otolaryngologists and audiologists who have been working directly with this new version of Earlens, and I've also spoken to some patients who've worn this new version of Earlens as well, and it seems as though a lot of the problems that they had with the first generation of this technology are significantly improved. Not only are audiologists reporting a higher rate of satisfaction when fitting the new Earlens system, patients are also reporting a high rate of satisfaction as well. When directly comparing clinician perceptions of the previous light-driven photonic version and the new inductive version, not a single clinician reported that the previous version was better, although 48% did report that the two systems were about the same. 30-day patient satisfaction ratings were also favorable for the new inductive Earlens system, where about 82% of users reported being satisfied or very satisfied. So what is the process of getting Earlens? Well, you actually have to see two types of professionals. You have to see a physician in the form of otologist or an otolaryngologist, and you also have to see an audiologist. This way, they can determine if you're a good candidate for Earlens based on your ear health and ear condition, as well as your audiometric data. If you have significant ear abnormalities like a perforated eardrum or exostosis that would actually block being able to put a lens on your eardrum, then you are not a good candidate. However, just like with traditional hearing aids, most forms of sensorineural hearing loss can be treated with Earlens. The audiologist may also have you listen to a comparator, which lets you compare the differences in sound between a hearing aid and Earlens. Ultimately, if you're a good candidate for Earlens and you decide to pursue treatment with Earlens, the next step is to get two impressions made. The first impression is an impression of your eardrum. That's right, they're actually going to take a physical impression of your actual eardrum so they can make the custom Earlens. The second impression is more of a traditional one where they would actually inject silicone material into your outer ear like they would do if they're just doing a regular ear mold. The first impression has to be done by the otologist or otolaryngologist, but the second impression can either be done by them as well or by the audiologist. Once the impressions are made, devices are ordered, and custom production begins with your ear tips and your lenses. This process takes about 2 weeks, and then once you come back into the clinic, the otologist or the otolaryngologist will actually place the lens on your eardrums, and then you'll go and see the audiologist where they will actually fit you with the processor in the ear tip and program those devices for you. This starts a series of fitting follow-up appointments over the course of the next couple months, and then over the course of the entire first year, you'll probably go in around quarterly to see your otologist as well as your audiologist. Okay, so that's roughly how the process of getting Earlens works. Yes, there is a lot of moving parts there, but let's get into some of the more interesting stuff, which is, what does the Earlens system look like? Now, when I go ahead and wear these devices, and give me a second here, because I'm gonna go ahead and put them in my ears to kind of show you what they look like. So there's the left one. I think that one was what, a silver one? This one here is more of a black color. But they look a lot like a traditional receiver in the canal hearing aid. Let me kind of center myself there, kind of show you this side, show you from behind, flip around, show you the other side, and from behind. I do notice that these wires right here, they do stick out a ways. That's the one thing about this is because this is not a rigid wire right here, it doesn't hold the form really tight up against the side of your head. These do feel a little bulky behind the ears, but after wearing them for a while, you probably wouldn't notice it that much. Overall, I would say that they are a pretty comfortable fit as long as the audiologist makes sure that they have a really good solid impression of your ear and make any modifications if necessary to the earpiece.
All right, guys, so I want to go ahead and show you a little bit more of a close-up of these custom lenses. Now, like I said, these are all custom, so they will be a little bit different. But I'm going to remove this one from the shipping container here and just set that off to the side so you can get a better size comparison with a dime. Now, what we're looking at right here, this red tip is the receiver coil. That is what is actually receiving the signal from the tip of the actual ear mold here, that little red coil that you can see right there. But let's get that out of the way and show you a little bit more about this lens. This silver piece right here is the motor. So that's what is actually creating the movement of this lens on the eardrum. And then if I flip it over here, this little piece right there actually makes contact with the eardrum, and more specifically the umbo of the eardrum. So it actually creates that vibration. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at the processors. I'm going to take them out of their charger case here. And as you can see, we have two different colors here. We have the black color and more of the silver champagne color. But the important thing to note here is that, again, this right here is the transmitter coil that will send a signal to the receiver coil that's inside of the lens. Now, the ear mold in and of itself has an open vent. You can see right through there, the bigger the better, and you don't lose any low frequencies when you have an open vent because we're using a direct drive system here. The material here is really soft silicone. You can see how it kind of squishes around there, so it gives a really comfortable fit inside of the ear. The wire that goes down to this tip, you can see that it's a little bit more rigid along the top right there, but then it dangles along the bottom. So that's why it doesn't contour with the side of the ear that well, as I showed you a little bit earlier. And then I'm going to switch over to this device here as I show you the push buttons. So you have an up push button and a down push button, and then you have a front and a rear microphone as well, very similar to a pretty traditional behind the ear or receiver in canal hearing aid. And as you can see, that this is a pretty hefty size device.
Like I mentioned before, you can stream audio directly from an iPhone into your Earlens devices, and you also get access to an app that allows you to do a few different things like change programs and change the volume levels. Now, as cool and as revolutionary as the Earlens system is, and it is pretty cool and it is pretty revolutionary, there are still a few negatives about this system. And the first negative is that the logistics of the fitting and maintaining process are really complex. In most cases with traditional hearing aids, you only need to see an audiologist. But in this case, you have to see an audiologist and you have to see an otologist or an otolaryngologist. And you have to basically bounce back and forth between the two of them. From a scheduling perspective, this can be a problem. And this develops into even more of a problem if you run into any issues with your devices. Because half the time, you're not really sure who you should go see. Should you go see the audiologist? Should you go see the medical doctor? If you go to see one and they're like, oh, that's not in my jurisdiction, you have to go see the other one, then you have to hope that the other one's actually available. Second is the fact that you can only stream from an Apple device. I happen to be primarily an Android user, but if you're an Android user, you can't stream audio into your Earlens devices. So if you happen to be an Android person, you're gonna have to switch over to be an Apple person. That being said, if you do not care about streaming whatsoever, and you don't care about having an app that lets you do remote control features, then basically, this is not a negative. Third is the price. Now, I happen to be a strong believer that you get what you pay for, and that having a high price tag on something generally means that that thing is going to be better for you. However, the question becomes, will Earlens provide you with twice the amount of value as a traditional premium level hearing aid that can be usually half the cost? Because premium hearing aid technology for both ears is generally going to run you between $6,000 and $7,500, but Earlens is generally going to cost you between $10,000 and $12,000. The fact that you have to see two different professionals to get this system fit and maintained is going to cost you more money. And the fourth negative is access to Earlens providers. Earlens is still a super new company, and even though they're adding new clinics across the United States, it can be still as difficult to find an Earlens clinic as it is to find a clinic that follows best practices when fitting hearing aids. However, it does appear as though Earlens has significantly improved upon their original design with a light-driven system by switching over to the inductive power system. I do expect to see more and more individuals gravitate over to Earlens if they can afford it and if they're not 100% happy with their traditional hearing aids. And of course, I always look forward to seeing more peer-reviewed studies comparing the performance capabilities of Earlens versus traditional hearing aids as more and more individuals start to adopt this revolutionary technology. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below. If you liked the video, please share it. If you want to see other videos just like this one, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Also, feel free to check out my website, drcliffaud.com.